Thank you. My name is Robin Harding. I'm the Tokyo Bureau Chief for the Financial Times. It's my pleasure to introduce today Ichiro Kawanabe, the chairman of Nihon Kotsu, which is, I think, the biggest taxi company in Japan. And he's also chairman of the Japan Taxi Association. So truly a man who knows his industry back to front. He has an MBA, he's a graduate of Keio University, has an MBA from Northwestern University in the US. He was a consultant at McKinsey before taking on his role in the family company. And I think that shows you he's not the standard taxi man. We think of taxis as being little independent one-man bands, but he is very far from that. He's a man with considerable and wide knowledge of business. There are many issues facing the taxi industry in Japan at the moment, from an aging population of drivers to the fares that are set, which there's recently been an adjustment in Tokyo. I hope we will find out the effects of that, to the potential for the sharing economy and the rise of Uber to affect the taxi industry in Japan as it has done abroad. I'd like to hand over now to Mr. Kawanabe for an initial presentation, and then he is ready to take your questions on every subject that takes your fancy. Thank you, Mr. Kawanabe.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Kawanabe, as kindly introduced.
私のキャリアがタクシーマンとして普通のものになるように将来になったらいいなと思います。
I'm hoping in the future that my background, my career will become the norm of a taxi man in the future.
こちら、今、当社日本交通のタクシー、都内に4000台走っておりますけれども、こちら見ていただきますと、このお腹にですね、タクシーアプリ、ジャパンタクシーという全国タクシーというタクシーアプリの宣伝をしております。
Now, as a matter of fact, we are Nihon Kotsu and we have some 4,000 taxis being driven. And if you look at the taxi cabs today, you see on the side of the taxi this Japan Taxi app, which is being promoted.
まさにこれが今、日本のタクシーが置かれている状況のそのままを表していると私は思っています。
And I believe that this does depict the reality that the Japanese taxis face today.
Uber は Uber であるんですけども、日本はタクシーがもともとたくさんあって、それなりの品質を担保してますので、それをいかに IT 化するかということによって、国民の足、公共交通機関タクシーをですね、より良いものにしていきたいと思っております。
Well, of course, on the one hand, there is Uber, but in Japan, we have already had a great number of taxis being utilized here, and also we have guaranteed to a certain extent the quality of the taxis. So the question here is how to introduce ICT so as to make the taxis an even better means of transportation for the public.
特に東京オリンピックがございますので、どうやったら海外にからいらしていただいた方もタクシーを使っていただく、まず最初に私が手をつけたのは、これは東京のタクシー協会の会長としてですね、730円だった初乗り運賃を410円に下げております、今年の2月からですね。
Mm-hmm. Well, and of course, there is the Tokyo Olympic Games coming up, and the question here is how to get the inbound visitors from overseas to use our taxis here. And I am the president of the Tokyo Taxi Association, so my first task as the president was to reduce the initial fare from 730 yen to 410 yen this February.
今日の為替レートで言いますと3ドル69セントいかがでしょうか、これで十分に安いと言っていただけるのか、しかもチップなしということですので、東京大きな都市ですので実際出来上がりは結構高くなるかもしれませんが、少なくともロンドン、ニューヨークのタクシーと同じか少し安いぐらいの値段まで下がったと思っております。
And well, according to the current today's foreign exchange rate, this would come to some $3.69. And of course, and you don't need to tip the driver here in Japan. And so how would you think of this price? Is it low enough for you? Or of course, in Tokyo, it's a big city, so you have to drive over a long distance. So the final fare might be relatively high, but we think that this is still at par or better than the taxis in London and New York.
その運賃をどうやって車の中で支払うのか、これ東京のタクシーの、東京そこら中にタクシーがありますので、 97% はですね、アプリとか電話で呼ばれるんじゃなくて、いわゆるストリートヘールでその道端で拾う、もしくは駅の前で乗る需要になっています。
Well, and so how are we going to get people to pay the fare inside the car? This is another challenge that we face. Now, looking at Tokyo today, 97% of the passengers do not really call or use apps to call a taxi instead. They just stop a taxi on the road or they take a taxi which is parked in front of the station.
ということは、パッと乗ったタクシーでどうやって2つのことを成し遂げるか、1つは行き先を伝える、もう1つは支払いをする。タクシー突き詰めると、この2つがの利便性を確保したいと思ってます。
And so the question is, well, you just happen to get onto a taxi cab which is just nearby, and I think there are two things that need to be achieved, and one is to enable the person to communicate the destination to which he or she wants to reach, and the other is the payment, so the fare payment, and I think ultimately these are the two things that we need to provide convenience for the passenger.
このタブレットで乗った瞬間にご自分の国の言語で設定をして、Google マップで行き先を入れていただいてもいいですし、もしくは自動音声翻訳をするという、これは今まだできませんけども、オリンピックまでにすることにしています。
Now, actually, the cabs come with a tablet. So using the tablet, you can set whichever language you want to communicate in. You choose the language and either use the Google map to designate where you want to go to, or it could be using audio recognition. You just say the destination and it will be automatically translated into Japanese. This is not feasible today, but we plan to be able to do this by the Tokyo Olympic Games.
すでに今東京の当社の4000台でできているのは、このペイメントの方はすでにできています。これは中国の方はあんまりいらっしゃらないかもしれません。中国の方であればアリペイ、ウィーチャットペイ、そしてアメリカ人の方であればクレジットカード、これはもともと結構ありますけども、日本人の方であればスイカ、これもありますが、例えば韓国の方であればカカオペイと、最近世界でどんどん広がっているスマホペイメントのインフラとして、こちらで QR コードで決済をいたします。
Now, and the other challenge, of course, is the payment. But we have already been able to achieve with our 4,000 vehicle fleet in Tokyo is that, supposing that you get onto the car, the passenger wants to make a payment. Well, there are not many Chinese in this room, so you might not know this, but there is this payment system called Alipay. And this is one payment, or the Americans are familiar with using credit cards to make their payment, and the Japanese would use their Suica cards to make payments, and Koreans, Kakao Pay would be another example. But at any rate, we have the infrastructure in the taxi so that people can use their smartphones to make the payment using the QR code.
今こちらはタクシー会社にはタダで提供しておりまして、そのためにこのサイネージ広告をから収入を得ています。
And of course, this service is provided free of charge by the taxi operators. And so, in order to compensate for that, we have signage ads. So we are trying to get advertisement revenue.
したがって東京のタクシー現在4万5000台ございますけれども、そのうち1万5000台個人タクシー、私が協会長を務める3万台の法人タクシーには全部これを乗せ、 なおかつ全国のタクシーにもできるだけ広げたいと思ってますね、あのオリンピックまでです。
And、currently there are some 45,000 cars and taxis being driven in Tokyo, of which 15,000 are the self-employed drivers, and、the remaining 30,000、would be corporate、taxi operators. And so,、of course,、being the Taxi Association、president, I want to first of all install this, to、these 30,000 taxis in Tokyo, plus I want to see that this system is introduced as many taxis as possible nationwide by the Olympic Games.
今年の10月の、いや今年の11月からですね、11月からこの新しいジャパンタクシーという名前の車両が走り出します。日本専用の設計のされたトヨタの全く新しいタクシー専用車両になります。
And、starting from November of this year, you'll be starting to see this new、what we call Japan taxi vehicles on the road.、as a matter of fact, these vehicles have been、produced、will be produced by Toyota. It is a car which has been exclusively designed for taxi purposes、for the Japanese market.
ロンドンのブラックキャブ、ニューヨークのイエローキャブ、そして東京、日本にはジャパンタクシーがあるという、東京のアイコンにしたいというふうに考えておりまして、タクシー業界全体でこれこの色、濃紺、ジャパンブルー、あの広重ブルーと言われる、この濃紺で揃えて、これは東京のその先ほどの法人タクシーの3台に1台、1万台を2020年までに入れます。
And of course, in London there is a black cab, and New York there's a yellow cab, and so we want to make this Japan、taxi an icon of Tokyo or、the Japanese、taxis in general. And the color will be navy blue,、what we call the Japan blue or Hiroshige blue color. And、we want to introduce this、to at least one third of、the、30,000 cars, corporate taxis that we have、by 2020 in Tokyo.
この車、11月から衝突防止ブレーキという先進安全装置がつきます。
And、so this、new cab, which will make its debut in November, will come with a very advanced safety feature, which is the anti-collision braking system.
多分タクシーの事故は半減すると思われます。
And we believe that the taxi accidents will be reduced to half.
そしてその向こうには2020年オリンピックの時にこちら車椅子がそのまま乗りますので、これを自動運転タクシーにしようというふうにトヨタとタクシー協会で今プロジェクトを進めております。
And、also、beyond、that、November date、by 2020 we want to see because、this vehicle、can carry the wheelchair user as is、we want to introduce autonomous driving、system to the taxi. So we have a project with Toyota, the、Tokyo Taxi Association, and we're working、to introduce an autonomous driving technology.
パラリンピックにいらしたパラリンピアンが当社のタクシーの行灯をつけたこの自動運転車で羽田空港からお乗りいただくと、おそらくその時運転席には若い女性の当社の運転手がいると思いますが、お乗せしてボタンをピッて押すと全くハンドルには触れず、アクセルも触れずにそのまま首都高速に乗り、そしてそのまま晴海ので首都高速を降り、オリンピックの選手村まで、これは必ず実現すると思います。
And、so supposing that a Paralympian who is taking part in the Paralympic Games arrives at the Haneda Airport, and、then in that case、that Paralympian will be able to board our company's、taxi with our、icon,、the、Sakura signage, and、it will be an autonomous driving vehicle. And therefore, from Haneda Airport,、this Paralympian will board the taxi, and at that time、there will be probably a lady driver.、 who will be assisting, but actually she will not be driving. She just has to press the button, and she doesn't have to even hold the steering wheel or apply the gas pedal. The car would automatically get onto the Shitoko Expressway, get off the expressway at Harumi, and head towards the Olympic Athletes Village. This will happen for sure.
その時にそのタクシー運転手の仕事は運転でなくて、おそらく英語で、あれが東京タワーですと、あれがレインボーブリッジですとか観光案内をし、なおかつこのおしぼりを出してですね、日本人としてのホスピタリティを演出するということになると思います。
Now at that time, what will be the task of this driver? It will not be the driver's task to drive the vehicle. Instead, in English, the driver will say, "What you see over there is Tokyo Tower, and over there is Rainbow Bridge." So, the driver will be providing some sightseeing information and also providing some hot towels as hospitality.
まあ、アプリの方も、このジャパンタクシーは今全国のタクシー24万台の2割以上5万台が参加をしております。
Now, meanwhile, as for the app, taxi app, of those Japan taxis nationwide, in total there are some 240,000 vehicles, 20%. In other words, 50,000 cars are participating, taking part in the app program.
このアプリで先ほどのジャパンタクシー車両をがこう呼んでくるんですが、あの車両ですと広いですから、これで相乗りをして、今までのタクシー運賃よりも安く、行くことができる。この相乗りのタクシーは今年の12月から実証実験を国土交通省と、いたします。
Now, as for the app, using the app, the people can call a Japan taxi car, and it is very roomy, and therefore it will be possible to do ride sharing on this taxi vehicle, meaning that you can split the fare, and it will be cheaper for the users. And we will start demonstration test with MLIT, the Ministry of Land, Infrastructure, Transport and Tourism, starting from December of this year.
最終的にはできれば千代田区と港区と中央区の間で、1ヶ月タクシー乗り放題で3万円とかですね、そういったこの乗り放題プランみたいなものができればいいなというふうに今は頭の中では考えております。
And I'm just thinking out loud right now. It is just merely a plan, but ultimately I would like to see, for example, that people are free to ride as much as they like in Chiyoda, Minato, and Chuo wards at a monthly fare of a fixed fare of some 30,000 yen.
このアプリ、まあ、Uber と違うのは、海外から3日間日本にいらした方がこのアプリをダウンロードするというのが結構大変ですので、そこは海外からいらした方が皆さん使うアプリと連携をしております。例えば東南アジアの方であれば LINE、まあアメリカ、欧米の方であれば Google マップからこの経路検索をすると当社のアプリが出てきます。
And this app, of course, unlike Uber, it will be difficult for those inbound tourists from overseas to try to download the app for their stay for example, 3 days in Tokyo. To make it easier for them to use, it will be linked to the apps that they already have. For example, if it's Southeast Asia, it will be Line, and the Americans and the Europeans, it will be Google Map. And so from there, they can link into our app so that they can utilize this app, our app.
ちょうど2週間前に韓国の、ドミナントなタクシー配車アプリであるカカオタクシーと、まあ、グローバルローミング連携というのを発表しました。これによって来年2月のピョンチャンオリンピックの時にはこのアプリを持った日本人がピョンチャンに行くとそのアプリで現地のタクシーを呼ぶことができます。
Just some 2 weeks ago, we have entered into an agreement with this South Korean dominant player, which is Kakao Taxi. And so we are not going to have global roaming with their app. And therefore, at the Pyeongchang Olympic Games, the Winter Olympic Games coming up next year, supposing that someone from Japan goes to South Korea, they can use their own app that they've been using in Tokyo and use this app to locally call a taxi in Korea.
その逆もまた真なりで、東京オリンピックまでにはそのカカオタクシーでをお使いの韓国人の方が東京にいらしたら、そのカカオタクシーのアプリで東京のタクシーを呼べる。こういったことを各地のナンバーワンアプリと連携をしていくつもりです。
And the opposite is also true. So by the Tokyo Olympic Games, these South Korean Kakao Taxi users, they can use their app to call a Tokyo taxi here in Japan. And so we want to enter into such alliance partnerships with the number one apps of different countries.
日本には24万台のタクシーがあると申し上げましたが、やっぱり日本全国つつ裏裏、そして、まあそれなりの高いですね、ホスピタリティを持ってサービスをさせていただいております。おそらく海外のタクシーと違うのは、全員が社員でして、我々は会社として、彼らはまあ、エンプロイーということになります。
And well, in Japan, there are in total some 240,000 taxi cars. And in all corners of Japan, there are these taxis which are providing high hospitality service. Now, unlike overseas, what's different here in Japan is that these taxi drivers are employees of the taxi operators. So we are hiring them, and they are our employees.
したがって我々はレーティングももちろん有効だと思いますけど、総合レーティング、ウーバーがやっているのはですね、ただ我々はまあプロの運転手として、安全性はもちろんのこと、サービスレベルもきちっと教育をしていきたいと。というふうに考えております。
And of course, I do understand that rating is effective. Like Uber, there is the mutual rating, but we want to see that our drivers are professionals who can guarantee safety and provide a certain high level of service. And we want to educate our drivers to be such.
最終的に日本でも。こちらのグラフを見ていただきますと、緑色の部分が人々が自家用車、車を運転して移動する、人口になります。黄色が電車、赤がバス、でタクシーはピンク色のわずか全体の 2% になっています。
Now, here in Japan, we give you this demographic breakdown, and the green represents the population which are using their own personal cars. And so you can see that a large part of the population using their own cars. And meanwhile, the yellow represents the population using trains, and the red is the bus. And the pink portion represents the taxi users, which accounts for only about 2%.
まあ、これだけの人が移動はたくさんしているわけですから、これからタクシーがテクノロジーによって、例えば相乗りに乗って半額になる、さらに自動運転によってもっと値段が下がってきます。そうしますと、この緑のところがやっぱりピンクに変わっていくと、したがってこのタクシーというものを IT 化することによって、新しい日本の公共交通インフラを作れるというふうに私は信じております。
Now, so I think that already there are quite a few people who are using different means of mobility, and if it should be that taxis they become cheaper due to the ride sharing, and it could be halved, and also as a result of autonomous driving, likewise this will help make the taxi ride cheaper, and then we will see more of the green population shifting to pink, andby introducing ICT to the taxis, I think taxis can become a new important means of public transportation, and I'm confident that we can build such an infrastructure.
最後になりますけども、まあ、ライドシェアというものに直面して、このタクシーがやるべきことは、 このレボリューションという変革というのも大事だと思いますが、我々せっかくいいスタンダードがあるのですから、これをさらに進化させることによって、日本の国民、それからもちろんビジターの皆様に、世界最高の乗車体験をお届けしたいと感じております。ありがとうございました。
And lastly, I'd like to say that in the face of this ride sharing trend that we see, what we, the taxi operators, should be doing, on the one hand, revolution is important, but to think of it, we already have a very good standard here in Japan, so we want to evolve this already good standard so that not only the Japanese users, but also the foreign visitorsComing to Japan can enjoy the world's best experience of riding a taxi. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kawanabe-san, for that presentation, which touched on most of the main themes. I'd like to open it up to questions now. Please raise your hand, come forward to speak at the mic, and state your name and affiliation before asking your question. Who would like to go first?
ペンとメモ帳貸してください。すいません。
I have to take notes. Excuse me.
Okay, Anthony Rally.
Anthony Rally, Singapore Business Times. I came in a little late, but what is your basic feeling towards the Uber concept? Are you in favor of it? Do you think it has a role to play in Japan?Or not. And I get the impression in Japan taxi usage is very high in Tokyo and in major cities, but outside of the cities, is taxi usage in Japan lower than elsewhere? And if so, would the Uber idea help in increasing taxi usage outside of the cities?
一部やっぱり人口の少ない過疎地域ではそういった動きも始まっておりますので、確かに過疎地域における交通の一つのやり方としてウーバーのスタイル、すなわち、タクシー免許を持ってない人が自分の車で移送するという形もあり得るのではないかというふうには考えております。
Well, yes, if you look around Japan, in some areas, you do see that there are such trends. For example, the rural areas where we see depopulation occurring, there is this room for the Uber approach to be adopted. In other words, these drivers who are not certified taxi-licensed drivers, they use their own personal car to transport people from one location to another.
But do you see, what do you think about the concept more broadly? Do you think that Uber should be able to operate in Tokyo? And in what way should they be able to operate in Tokyo?
なぜ Uber が東京でその規制されているかと、まあ、皆さんご存知のように Uber は今現在タクシーとハイヤーすなわち、まあ、プロの運転手 の、 アプリとしては東京で機能しております。
Well, yes, so why is it that Uber is regulated here in Japan, in Tokyo, that is, and right now, the Uber, yes, the application is that it is applicable to, what is that,
タクシーとハイヤーを呼び出すアプリという形で機能はしています。
Yes, excuse me. So the Uber app is applicable. It can be used to call taxis or hired cars, as we call them, the limousines and with chauffeurs, these professional drivers. It can be used to call these cars.
ですから、プロフェッショナルじゃない個人の車を呼ぶというスタイルは日本ではやっぱり今禁止されていると。
And in other words, in Japan, there is a prohibition to call these cars, which are personal cars, driven by non-professionals.
But do you think that is good or bad?
now, 私自身がそれを判断するというのはなかなか難しいんですけども。 それが許されている国というのはアメリカと中国しかないんですね。今例えばロンドンでもパリでもウーバーポップは禁止されました。そのすなわち全く レジスタードされない全くの普通の個人の車で輸送するというのはやっぱり世界各国で禁止されております。ただしイギリスで言えばあのミニキャブと、まあ、その完全なる自家用車でなくてやはり登録された非常に規制の緩いプロの車を安く手配することができると、まあ、日本にはそのカテゴリーというのがなかなかないというか、まあ、タクシーがそのカテゴリーを兼ねていたということだと思います。はい。
Well, it's first of all very difficult for me personally to make that judgment. But if you look around the world to those countries where Uber is allowed, it's only in the United States and China that the Uber system is totally permitted. If you go to London or Paris, there is a prohibition on the Uber pop. And it's not the case where people can freely get a Lyft on these personal cars which are not registered. And so I think worldwide, with a few exceptions, there is this prohibition in place. In the UK, though, there is the minicab, and so this is a case where they have a looser regulation, but still they're professional drivers. And if you were to use this minicab, it would be cheaper. But in the case of Japan, we don't have that category. I think taxis have been belonging to this category and compensating for this category.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay, Anthony, you want to follow up?
To follow up with another question.
Okay.
How widely do you think this concept of autonomous cabs or autonomous driving is going to be used? I mean, frankly, it scares me, the thought of at this stage, and yet you seem to be suggesting that by the time of the Olympics, autonomously driving cabs will be quite a common. Are you satisfied the level of safety is such that can you guaranteed safety?
もちろんそのトヨタがトヨタの安全基準を満たす車を我々が使ってという前提になりますので相当コンサバティブになるとは思います。
Well, of course, the premise here is that these vehicles will have to satisfy Toyota's very stringent safety regulations, standards, and also we will be using those vehicles. So I think that we will be very conservative in introducing this system.
実はタクシーは自動運転車両、自動運転テクノロジーというものの、まあ、を広げるですね、広告宣伝ととしての役割を果たせると私は思っています。
And I personally think that taxis can be a promoter like an ad banner to promote autonomous driving technology.
やはりタクシーは一般の車の7倍走行いたします。最初の自動運転タクシーはもちろん車両は高い値段になるはずですからそれをたくさん走るタクシーが利用することによって一般の方が自分で買う前にタクシーで自動運転を経験することになると思われます。それでおそらく運転手さんと話しながらおこんなになってんの、あ大丈夫そうだよとこういう、世の中に広めていく役割ということが果たせるんじゃないかと思ってます。
Well, of course, these autonomous driving vehicles, they will be very expensive cars, and therefore you have to recognize that taxi cars are driven 7 times more the distance than ordinary personal cars, and therefore it would be wise to get these taxis to first use these very expensive cars, and then I think the general public would get on the car and see what autonomous driving is like before purchasing a car themselves. And they would get to see and ask the driver all sorts of questions. They come to understand what it's like, and they would come to think it's okay. So I think that these taxis have a role to promote autonomous driving.
Okay, thank you. Who else would like to ask a question? Gentleman at the front there.
Thank you very much for your speech. My name is Yusuke Wada. I'm associate member. I run an IT company as well as funeral company as well. And I do undertakers trucking business as well. Reikyu Shindai yattemasu. And what we are concerned is that companies like Uber, if they do come up with a funeral industry, we don't have enough workforce right now picking dead people from hospital to back home or wherever the destination is. And to get a Reikyu Menkyo, it takes 6 months in Kanagawa-ken. But in Tokyo, it takes about a month to 3 months, which is very fast. Mm. The thing is, if people like in the workforce, in an Uber kind of company, gets a Reikyu Menkyo, they would definitely be able to infiltrate that industry. Would the taxi industry be willing to do that kind of work?
Uber に取って代わってということですか。
はい、あ、ウーバーを取って代わって、タクシー業界の方々がそういう連休免許をなさるでしょうかと。
なるほど。そうですね。考えてもいませんでしたが、可能性としてはもちろんないとは言えないと思いますし、まあ、非常に近いやっぱりホスピタリティが重要な業界だと思いますので、ビジネスチャンスをありがとう。
Well, I've never thought of it really, but I don't think I should rule out that possibility. Yes, I think it's quite close to what we are doing, since that funeral service, the type of thing, does require hospitality as well. So thank you for giving me that idea of a new business opportunity.
Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, the gentleman here.
Hi, my name is Reed Stevenson from Bloomberg. I'm a user of both the Japan Taxi app, and I was a frequent user of the Uber app before coming to Tokyo last year. So I have a few questions. I guess the biggest one is it's very easy to find a car with a Japan Taxi app in Tokyo, where there are a lot of taxis. But I found it very difficult to find a taxi outside of the center of Tokyo, in western Tokyo, or even in Kyoto. So I think there's still probably a lot of work that needs to be done, but what is necessary to increase the availability of taxis outside Japan? The second one is, why do you still charge the 400 yen fee for calling a taxi when obviously Uber doesn't have a similar fee? But the one thing I will say is I think a lot of good work has been done on the payment side. So it's quite seamless and almost as good as Uber, I think. It would be nice to get the receipt with the map, though.
大変たくさん利用していただいてありがとうございます。
I appreciate that you're a heavy user.
おっしゃる通り、東京のユーザビリ、東京でのユーザビリティと特に関西とか東京以外でのユーザビリティがちょっと差がついてきてしまっておるのが今、まあ、その会社を運営する社長としての悩みであります。
Well, as you rightly pointed out, if you were to compare the usability in Tokyo versus other areas like Kansai, there is a gap. And being the president, yes, this is an issue that I really have to address.
それはやはりタクシー業界にまだ6000社日本でありまして、それはやっぱり規制があってある程度ちっちゃい会社も守られてきたというのも事実なんですよね。
Well, partially the reason is because we have so many taxi operators in Japan. There are as many as 6,000 taxi companies in Japan, and this is partially due to the fact that even the small players have been protected by regulation in the past.
ですからもしもうこれからついていけないという方は、まあ、例えばそうやっぱり買収をさせていただいたりフランチャイズに入っていただいたりして最終的にやっぱりもう日本中のタクシー会社がまあこういったテクノロジーをやっぱり活用していただくという必要があって、まあ、そこにはまだちょっとメンタルギャップというかやっぱりまだ世界でライドシェアが求められているというかその世界で例えばUberがもたらしているユーザビリティみたいなものあまりまだ知らないタクシーの会社の社長さんも いらっしゃいますので、そこはまあ私の責任としてですね、しっかりと働きかけていきたいと思っております。
Well, and eventually there will be those taxi companies which say that they cannot keep up with such technology. In that case, it could be that we would have to acquire that company, or it could be that they join and become a franchise, etc. So ultimately, I think it will be necessary for even these companies to try to leverage this technology that is available. But I think that there is still this mental gap, so to say, and not always these presidents of taxi companies appreciate the fact that ride sharing is becoming quite popular because of Uber and the usability provided by Uber. And so there are presidents who are not aware of this, and as my responsibility, I think I need to approach such taxi companies.
それからタクシーをこのアプリで呼んでいただいた時に410円と今迎車料金というのがかかります。でそのおっしゃる通りちょっと、これはもうもう少しやっぱり下げていかないといけないなというふうに一消費者としても感じておりますし、まあ、初乗りが下がったことによってまたその相対的なイメージが高くなりましたので、ですからもし、まあ、ちょっとすぐにはなくせないかもしれませんが、精一杯下げるようにですね、努力いたします。
And about this 410 yen fee that is charged when you call a taxi using the app, yes, we do have such a system, and we understand that we must try to reduce this fee. As a consumer, I do appreciate that point, and especially the fact that because the taxi, the first ride, has become cheaper here in Tokyo, in relative terms, this fee appears to be quite expensive. So we have to make every effort to try to reduce this fee.
And your final point was
it was a compliment.
Oh, it was a compliment. Okay.
引き続きご利用よろしくお願いします。
Can we have the map with the receipt? Can we have the map with the receipt? I think you suggested.
Map?
So the Uber receipt has a map.
I'll work on that.
I'll just see if anyone else wants any other questions in the room. The gentleman here, and then Anthony.
フリーランスの亀松と申します。先日たまたま利用したタクシーが日本交通さんのタクシーで、乗ったらですね。自分の前にタブレットが設置されていて、はい、でそこで、まあ、いろんな情報が、まあ、デジタルサイネージで流れていたんですが、まあ、ニュースも流れていまして、具体的にフォーブスの、記事が流れていたりしました。で今日のお話の中でですね、まあ、情報メディアとしてのタブレットのお話がありましたが、今後そこのメディア的な部分ですけれども、もっと強化していこうとされているのかどうか、まあ、確かにこの目の前に座っている間にですね、どういう情報を伝えるかというのは、まあ、非常に大きなチャンスでもあると思うんですが、そういうデジタルサイネージを使って、まあ、例えばもっと多様なメディア企業と提携して、まあ、例えば電車の中では今いろいろ情報が流れていますけど、そういうニュース的なものをもっと発信していくのか、あるいは広告的なものも、まあ、具体的には今フリークアウトさんと組んでですね、やられてますけれども、そういう広告をもっと活用していくとか、いわゆるメディア的な側面についてどのようにお考えかを伝えいただければと思います。
いいですか、すみません。I'll translate that. My name is Kamematsu, a freelance writer, and I have a question. It so happens that the other day I got on a Nihon Kotsu taxi car, and there was this tablet installed in front of me, and there was a lot of information being conveyed through the digital signage, and it was partially news, the Forbes articles, and so I was wondering how keen you are to try to further boost the IT media, the media part, using the tablet, and so I think that of course it's important to try to think about what information convey to a passenger. sitting in the back of this taxi and having this tablet in front. And so using this digital signage, are you planning to get more media companies signed up so that they can report, deliver more news? Or are you going to use it more for advertisement? I think you have a tie-up with Freakout right now. So what is your approach towards media?
まさにこれをどうやってそれを使ってこのご乗車いただいているこう乗車体験を向上するかというのは今日々研究中でございまして、もし何かいいアイデアがあればぜひ教えていただきたいですし、今やってますのは少なくともそこに出すのなるべくニュースと、あとまあ広告でもですね、今そこのインカメラがついていて、そのカメラで今は男性か女性かを一応判断して、まあ、女性の方にはその男性っぽい広告は出ないということをやっております。これをもう少し突き詰めていくと、やっぱり乗った時にやはり自分にフィットした広告が出せるようになる。さらにその位置情報を活用して、その行き先の近くにある美術館の展示内容をお知らせするとかですね、そういったやっぱり移動と情報を持っているメディアとしての活用方法を今後模索していきたいというふうに考えております。
Yes, and right now we are in the process of researching how we can try to provide better experience to the passengers while they are riding the car. And this is a thing that we are researching, and if you should come up with good ideas, we'd more than welcome you giving us those ideas. But what we're trying to do now is to, on the one hand, provide news and also advertisements. There is this in-camera inside the car, and it can judge whether the passenger is a woman or a man, a male or female. And making that judgment, supposing that you judge, the camera judges that it is a female passenger, and then we will not run advertisements which we think would be more fit for men to watch. And so we are trying to do such things. And if we can go down further down the road, it could be that using the destination information, the positioning of the passenger, we could provide information like art exhibition which is being exhibited near the destination of that passenger, etc. So we are going to try to use this mobility information and try to use media to fit the various needs of the passengers.
Okay, thank you. Anthony, you had another question. Has anyone else got questions?Okay.
I'm not an expert at all on autonomous driving, as must be clear from my questions. But when we say autonomous driving, we do mean without a driver, presumably. And presumably that requires a certain amount of infrastructure. When I say infrastructure, I mean sensors and all kinds of things that tell the taxi when it's approaching a danger area and so on and so forth. This applies obviously not just to taxis, but to other drivers too. But does this infrastructure exist in Tokyo to the extent that you'll be able to offer extensive taxi services by the time of the Tokyo Olympics? And perhaps a rather silly question, but if you call an autonomous cab and you're on your way to somewhere and someone else calls it, does it automatically stop and pick up extra passengers en route?
あの首都高速であればすでにトヨタは全部できるというふうに、公式見解で発表はされてないですけど、私は感じています。で特に羽田空港から豊洲までというのは一直線ですね、実は結構簡単です。ですから高速に関しては非常に進むというふうに思われますし、まあ、いわゆる ETC ゲートを通ってから ETC ゲートのところまでは、これはまあ自動運転タクシーもそうですし、皆様方のプライベートカーでも相当進むんじゃないかと、早い段階ですね、思います。
Well, first of all, when it comes to the Shitoko Expressway, though Toyota has not made this official and made any official statement, I personally feel that they can manage if it is the expressway from, for example, Haneda Airport to Toyosu. And because it's a pretty easy route, it's straight, and therefore I think that if it's between the toll gate, the ETC toll gate from one location, the Haneda Airport to Toyosu, です。ETC Tollgate, I think this is going to be quite feasible in the near future. And it doesn't have to be just taxis, but also personal cars as well.
やっぱ全自動運転車が一般的になるには技術的な側面ともう一つやっぱり経済的な側面があると思ってます。要するに技術的にはやっぱり道がある程度広くてですね、あんまり混んでない。そうするとやっぱりカリフォルニアとかですね、東京でもまあ田舎とかで、東京でやっぱり世田谷区とかですね、どうしてもこれも永遠に無理だというふうに言われてますし、ですからそういった地理的な状況が技術面で非常に大事になってくるのと、あともう一つはやっぱり人件費の安いところではドライバーが運転した方が圧倒的安いので、自動運転車はなかなか進まないと言われてます。したがって、シリコンバレーは人件費も高くて道も広いので一番最初に進むのは間違いなくてですね、日本は人件費が高いですから、お金の面では整いますけども、おそらく道という面ではですね、やっぱり環状線以外は難しいんじゃないかと思われます。そうするとおそらくその自動運転タクシーが自動で走るところと、そこからはその近辺にローカルな、本当にローカルな運転手がいて、そこからちょこちょこっと運転するとかですね、そういった新しい形態のタクシーっていうのが生まれるんじゃないかと私は想像しております。
Well, but yeah, when you talk about fully autonomous cars and whether this will become the norm, generally accepted, I think this requires people to look into two aspects. One is the technical side, the other is the economic side. And for the technical side, first you require wide roads, which have a little congestion. So California would be an optimum location. Whereas Tokyo, I think you would have to go to the outskirts of Tokyo to have and such conditions in place. I think Setagaya Ward would be impossible. I mean, no matter how long you take, it would be impossible to introduce autonomous driving. So there is this geographical requirement, technical requirement on the one hand. And the other is the economic side, the personnel cost. Well, if it's cheap in that country, then you might as well hire a driver rather than introduce this technology. So we don't think that autonomous driving would prevail that much. Whereas in case of Silicon Valley, I think they have the conditions in place. The personnel cost, labor cost is high. Also, they have wide roads. And so I think the Silicon Valley might be one of the first to introduce this system. Whereas in case of Japan, yes, the labor cost is high. But when it comes to the roads, the wide roads, I think you would have to drive over the major roads.The expressways and major roads to be able to use this system. And maybe you have autonomous driving on those expressways or the major roads. And once you come closer to the destination where there are very narrow alleys, roads, it might be that a local driver hop onto the taxi and start driving. So there might be totally new ways of taxi driving in the future. I'm just imagining these things right now.
Okay, thank you very much. I'd like to ask a couple of questions, if that's okay. First, could you give us a quick idea of the results of the 410 yen fare? Has it increased ridership? What have the effects been? That's one question. Second question, we hear a lot about labor shortages across Japanese industry now. How is that affecting the taxi industry?
410円はやる前は非常にいろいろな批判的な声が多かったんですが、やった後はですね、実は多くの良かったという声が寄せられています。あれの仕組みとしてはですね、実はその完全に前の方を値下げしたわけではなくて、その組み替えということで前の方を下げさせていただいて、後ろの方をちょっと上げさせていただいて、トータルとしてイコールという形になっています。したがって、本当はその安く済んだっていう方の裏には実はちょっと上がったっていう方もいらっしゃるんですね。 ですからこれはトータルとしてもし乗車人数が同じであれば同じになるという形なんですが、やっぱり人数としては安くなった方の方が多いんです。短距離乗りの方は乗車人数が非常に多いですから、ですから声としては基本的にはいいというふうにされていて、まあ、我々インダストリーとしても全体として売上が少し数パーセント上がっておりますので、我々としては非常にありがたいなというふうに思っています。
Well, yes, first of all, about the 410 yen fare, yes, before we introduced the system, there was a lot of criticism. But once it was introduced, I think there were more positive comments coming in towards this change. As a matter of fact, it's not the case where we totally reduced the fare. Instead, we made a difference in the way the fare is charged. So those people who ride only short distance would be able to benefit from cheaper fares, whereas those people who use it over a longer distance might find that they have to pay slightly more than in the past. So in total, it's designed to be more or less the same revenue for us, and provided that the ridership remains the same. Now, so if you look at the results of this new fare system, yes, in terms of the number of users, we see that there has been more increase in those users who are using it over a short distance. In other words, who are paying less than in the past, and those who are driving using long distance are not as increasing that significantly. So, but as a feedback, we hear a lot of positive statements, and also for the industry, we have seen that our turnover has increased by a few percentage points. So we're very thankful for that.
で、労働者が見つからない、労働人口が減っているという話においては、少なくとも大都市のですね、タクシーは実は。それはまず事実でありまして、タクシー業界もですね減っています。でそれに対して実は大都市、東京、大阪、名古屋、神戸、札幌、福岡、大体その後、仙台も含めてその辺りの大都市では今、新卒乗務員という採用を始めてまして、これが実は非常にうまくいき始めております。4大を卒業した人がすぐにタクシードライバーになると、彼にとってみれば十分な収入で、なおかつ毎日自分が社会貢献しているという感覚が非常に得られて、その結果今初めて5年になりますけども、離職率が3年で 15% という普通の業界の半分になっています。ですから少なくとも大都市ではこれをもってですね、逆転させることは難しいかもしれませんが、少なくとも補うことは十二分にできると思っております。
Yes, as for the labor shortage question that you mentioned, yes, it is a fact. Even in the taxi industry, we are seeing that we have less labor force in our industry. But if you look at the major cities, for example, places like Tokyo, Osaka, Nagoya, Kobe, Sapporo, Fukuoka, Sendai, in those big cities, we have introduced this system where students fresh out of university, four-year universities, immediately start to work as taxi drivers, and they can earn enough income, and every day they have a feeling that they're making contribution to society. And it's 5 years since the system has been introduced, and the turnover rate is 15% in 3 years time. So I think this is about half the industry, the normal industry standard, and therefore I think we have been quite successful with this system. And at least in the major cities, this has not really reversed, and we don't say that we have a labor force surplus these days, but at least it's been helpful in compensating for the shortage that we had had in the past.
Okay, well, we're out of time, so I would like to thank Kawanabe-san for his interesting presentation and for candidly addressing everybody's questions. You join me in thanking him for an excellent presentation. Thank you.
どうもありがとうございました。